Hey everyone, we're at the 2017 Art on the Millrace, but we started our tour with the Hawks building, and this is a residence for artists, entrepreneurs, and creative people. And we've been to the end of the first floor, but we're going back now and I'm going to show you some of the arts that we saw. Let's go. Art on the door, and a beautiful apartment building for artists. This is the corridor, well lit wall with art on it. Beautiful. Origami art. Amazing. Origami is practical science with NASA, because that's how they folded all the solar panels in the spaceship to take it to space, and then unfold it so that it could collect sunlight and generate power or electricity for the whole contraption. So when your child is doing origami, don't stop them. It could help NASA. This one's amazing drawing by Jonathan Rule. Nice sketches. Charcoal pencil, I think. Lead painting, or lead drawing. Take a closer look. Looks like some futuristic apocalyptic Earth. Maybe he'll animate it into a movie. Maybe.
That one was pencil.
Okay, this octopus. Well, quadrupox, I guess, because it's got like four legs. Pencil. And this is octopus.
It's pencil.
Well, almost completed.
And then a jelly.
Moving on.
More
origami. More art by Jonathan. Origami crystal. Argument mixed media. Some painting. Oh, it's okay. And more art. Okay. Handcrafted jewelry by Emily Ray. And this is the one my daughter was excited about, the geode necklace. Why did you buy the Wakarusa thing then? Alright. How about now we're going to go talk to Jonathan and we'll take a trip to the second floor. See you then. So we made it to the second floor of the Hawk building where all the arts are placed, and we're just going to go around. We're at the end of it and we're going to go back to the other end, so we'll show you how. Hello. Well, there's an art piece here, but without a name or title, so we're just gonna go. And a mixed medium art here. And we just went in there and saw amazing art. And, by When Mother Whistles by Susan Adamek. three art pieces hanging here. And we've just been to Suzanne's apartment to check out her creative space. Very organized creative space. And she does mixed media art, as you can see. Some cutouts and other materials. 3D stuff. You know, you can touch, feel.
Yeah.
Amazing artwork. Susan says she's been in the corporate world for a long time, and then she just, when she retired, she took up art and she's never leaving it.
No.
Amazing stuff. This is also by Idris, specializes in oil painting. We're going to take a tour of her apartment and art and creative space. It was amazing. I also came to see art from Bruce. Bruce has pottery and ceramic stuff. And they have some cookies. Now I can't talk. Need something to drink too. At the same time. Are you drinking? Try a little. No? Okay. All right, we'll continue our tour right now. Let's go.
Forgot that.
Oh. This one's called Diving Deep. And it's by Idris, yogurt.
Oh, not deep.
Yeah, she intended to make it shallow, but as you can see, it's like dark colors, so it's Diving Deep instead. Oh. And if you haven't seen this, these are the
Goshen rocks.
Goshen rocks. Popping up every place around the city of Goshen. Look one of
them.
Why do I have to put it in my
pocket?
Another painting by Idris. Mixed media by Susan.
Again,
yes. Oil painting by Idris. Mixed media by Susan again. And then this is art pieces by Mildred. This one is called A Good Day. Mildred is from Puerto Rico. And this one's called Azul, which means blue in Spanish. And this is called Believe. This one's another painting from Mildred, titled Rainbow. We have other paintings here in print format. Turtle by Peggy Stickler. Goshen Rivera by Steve Yoder again. Royal Flush by Erica Lent. Mixed Media. Featuring Donald Trump. And Flower with Sunset. Peggy Stickler. And this one is by Erica Linton. It's titled The American Girl. Now this about concludes our tour of art in the Ox Building. Me and Sunay are going to go to the Millrace and see what's happening there and talk to some people doing pottery and art and stuff before we head back. See you then. How long have you been doing this?
How long have I been painting?
Doing art and painting in general?
Painting in general for maybe about 8 years now. And then art, like, my whole life.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
And have you been doing it, have you lived in Goshen all the while doing this?
Yeah. All went to school here, graduated. Just trying to make it.
Wow.
Trying to move west coast.
Oh, okay. Is this your first exhibit here at the Millrace?
No, this is my second time doing it. I did it the first year, which was like maybe 2 years ago.
Uh-huh.
And then came back here just before I move out to West Coast. Moving to Vegas.
Oh, Vegas.
Yeah, so. Okay.
Nice.
Get some extra money before I move out there.
Oh, good.
Yeah. But I'm still trying to pursue art, yeah.
Oh, while in Vegas.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe do some other things, like other hobbies, you know, but art will always probably be like, it'll probably always be the thing that I was pursuing.
Good.
Yeah, thank you for asking.
Hey, no problem. So, and the Millrace now, what do you think about it? I mean, you saw the first one, and I think this is the third.
I think I was more ready for it the first time, this time around.
Mm-hmm.
Only because, like, I came with a friend, and she kind of, like, bailed on me. So that always, like, sucked. But, yeah, I mean, it's still fun. I mean, all that being out here and meeting everybody and getting everybody's feedback and stuff about things is always really nice. So I guess it's kind of like give or take how you look at it.
Yeah, that was at the first year too.
Oh, really?
I can say it's bigger now because I was with.
There's like rows. Yeah. Rows.
That was with Sunday then, and we were behind someone.
Oh, I see. So, okay.
You know Sunday, right?
Yeah.
The Italian sculptor.
Yep.
So.
I feel you.
He's not here.
All right. I think we are done. Do you want to see that? I think she has a picture of it. She has a lot of pictures of it. You don't want to lose it. Oh.
Ooh yeah, yeah. This is a song for all humanity.
Listen.
Alright. Yeah. I and I is one blood. I and I live in one world. Humanity is one of a kind. Every tribe, every people, in temples and the steeples, lift up your voice in one accord. Speak out for peace and justice for all. Humanity can live together as one. And if we unite, there'll be no more war. Will the world that just survive, we will thrive as one. Yeah.
I and I
is one blood. I and I lives in one world. I and I have one life. I and I is one world. From the West Indies to the North, to the South of Africa, Africa. People cry, people fight, people die, and television amplifies. But there's more good in the world than what the media proclaims. We got to speak up for higher standards so that the world can change. Speak out for peace and justice for all. So that humanity can live together as one. And if we unite, there'll be no more war. Will the war that just survive, so we will thrive as one, yeah.
I and I
is one blood. I and I